Welcome to Unfiltered. Here's tonight's headline, WTF. President Trump's joint press conference with Russian President Vladimir Putin was nothing short of stunning and frankly indefensible. If Trump isn't a Russian agent, he sure plays a good one on TV. I can't think of a press conference between any two world leaders in which one leader so thoroughly trampled on his own nation and its interests than the suck-up fest I witnessed this afternoon. Take this moment when President Trump was asked if he believed his own intelligence agencies in their conclusions on Russian meddling in the 2016 election.
All I can do is ask the question. My people came to me, Dan Coats came to me and some others. They said they think it's Russia. President Putin. He just said it's not Russia. I will say this. I don't see any reason why it would be. I have great confidence in my intelligence people, but I will tell you that President Putin was extremely strong and powerful in his denial today.
Trump can appreciate a skilled liar when he sees one. Mind you, this comes mere days after 12 Russian intelligence officers were indicted for their role in interfering in the U.S. election, a day after a Russian national was arrested on charges of spying on the U.S., and days after Director of National Intelligence Dan Coats compared the warning signs of attacks on our digital infrastructure to those the U.S. faced ahead of the September 11th terror attacks. President Trump, in full view of the world, is giving more value to the word of Putin, a known liar, than he is the thousands of members of his own intelligence community whose conclusions we rely on in order to keep us safe. But wait a second, somehow it got even worse. Here's what Trump had to say about the probe into Russia's election meddling.
President Putin may very well want to address it, and very strongly, because he feels very strongly about it, and he has an interesting idea.
Is that idea not doing it anymore? Nope.
He offered to have the people working on the case come and work with their investigators with respect to the 12 people. I think that's an incredible offer. Okay, thank you.
Yes, let's put the arsonists in charge of investigating how the building burned down. In a bizarre twist, if you were looking for a redeeming moment, if you were looking for the projection of American strength, you'd have to look to Putin for that. Here's what he said when asked if Trump brought up Russia's annexation of Crimea.
The posture of President Trump on Crimea is well known, and he stands firmly by it. He continued to maintain that it was illegal to annex it. Our viewpoint is different. We held a referendum in strict compliance with the UN Charter and the international legislation.
Make no mistake about it, Putin got everything he could have possibly wanted and more out of this meeting. What did Trump get? He got a soccer ball for Barron. Here's the deal. I don't even know where to begin. The jokes write themselves. Trump was so impotent, it's no wonder he leaves the Russian summit with one ball. Or with Trump's penchant for gag orders, I wouldn't have pegged him as a submissive. Or not since the end of the continuation war in 1944 has Finland seen such a conclusive surrender to Russian dominance. You history buffs know what I'm talking about. Except what happened this morning in Helsinki was no joke. It was an abomination. Trump made a mockery of the U.S. presidency today. He made a mockery of our country and our shared values today. He took his reality show circus abroad to tell a murderer and a liar that he deserves our trust, that he can call the shots, and that he can put us in our place. Of course, plenty of Trump supporters will find insane ways to defend Trump's performance today, but none will justify this. None will redeem the fact that this president made a laughingstock of our great nation. They'll rock themselves to sleep tonight to MAGA lullabies, but when they wake up, the world will be just as they left it, with Putin the winner and Trump the loser. Spasiba, President Trump.